to get up here and entertain us for a minute. We're still counting votes. Robbie's going to get up here and entertain us for another quick minute, and then we're going to give you your Valentine's prizes. Give it up right now for Robbie!
So, I work weekdays on Sundays on the weekends, so it's my rare chance to be here. So I'm going to take this moment to do a poem that's the most fun for me to perform. I love doing what you're looking at right now more than anything I can think of. So I'm going to do one about the experience of getting stuff on the paper better, more easily, better, whatever. Okay. Look, I just want to move you. Woo you, shake you loose but never lose you. I want to savor the glazed reverent silence of your gasping, ungrasped breath. Sip it down till there's nothing left, yet still explain all the rest. See, it's time I unearth some gold. Nothing here sold, just given freely to slurp up, served up cold. But I dare not go it alone. Not when there's so many helping hands beyond my own. So I first court eloquence. She's an easy enough mark to find. Volubly masticating volumes while leisurely lathering her tan leathered skin. Dolloping her monocle body features in librarian sin, she says to me, my dear boy, berate the not with your full stark lethargic oddities, your penchant melancholic falsities. You must but grunt through the treasury of your muddy misgivings, and both only accessible, pertinent notions, neither precarious nor incongruous to the truth. Robbie, you must simply relinquish your intrepid frenzied paucities. Okay, so I dismissed the diss since, well, her big scary words are kind of lost to me. Evidently, though, I must need a Joe Blow, an everyman, a street corner clairvoyant. I turn to raunchiness. His beer belly dick and fart jokes and dollar store aftershaves suggest a pleasing pull my finger charm that just might turn the trick. He licks his lips and chides through a buck-toothed, spit-shine smile. Shee, you ball out there one's easy. All you got to do is go down deep and speak from your gut. Tell them how you feel, how you really feel. Tell them, shoot, tell them they're looking just right. You just might feel as horny as a gas gauge after a good pump. As dirty as a Mickey D's wrapper, corner pinch discarded like a used diaper hammock. Yeah, you tell them you're as trashy as a receptacle for used diaper hammocks. Yes, yeah, boy, girls will eat that shit up. And say you're as gay as rainbow gold, as straight as an arrowhead, as misled as finding your folks are still sex fiends, or as contradictory as dicks like me. Boy, you are as confused as the lumpy, stumpy, piddly, dimple teen who finds out Santa Claus is real and he's hanging out loose in every single Hustler magazine. Now, Andy boy, if they still don't care, or they see that you're scared, just say you feel as guilty as midnight dials from parents of girls gone wild, sneering, well, shoot, sugar plum, you sure ain't been feeling real secure in a while. And as he loosely labels me, as awkward as anal thermometers, as misunderstood as butt plugs, I give Rogers a dismissive shrug and return to the mystery of what I've missed from me, whatever still may be my own poetic style. You kiss the dog? Okay. This is what I, yeah, like, do I clap for that show? We're back to actual love poems. When he grows up, he wants to be a UFO pilot. He tugs my sleeve, and his father reminds him to be careful not to spill people's beer. Go inside, his father says. This is grown-up time. I don't know why he sounds just like raunchiness.
Can I play your PlayStation, Dad?
No, leave my shit alone. I imagine my friends on his beer-stained couch with a video game pad plugged into the base of his boy's skull, thumbing him around the room like a remote-controlled vacuum cleaner. The kid looks at me and I shrug. Earlier he'd asked me if I thought that we were born to love love too. And his father said, "Don't be stupid," before I could tell him, "Yeah, as a matter of fact, I do." So I had no way of printing my stuff, so I could email it to myself. It's crazy that we have phones that are actually smarter than ourselves. So this is an experience of someone I saw bumping into someone else at a grocery store in the fruit section. Each wrong turn leaves a scar on the stippled lining of my psyche. So when I turned around abruptly and knocked the avocado from your hands, I stuttered an apology and tried to explain about wrong turns and scars while a blemish crept across the surface of the peach I was holding. "But wrong turns are not always random events," you said, as you surveyed the fruit in my basket. "Our meeting here might yield fruit of..." Oh man, that's a friend. Sorry, someone's calling me of all times, right? I don't even find where the heck I was. I stuttered an apology and tried to explain about wrong turns and scars while a blemish crept across the surface of the peach I was holding. "But wrong turns are not always random events," you said, as you surveyed the fruit in my basket. "Our meeting here might yield fruit of unknown sweetness," you whispered, between the lines of your own apology. Then you explained how each wrong turn leaves a bruise on the plump, smooth lining of your psyche. We blushed strawberry red when we realized how much we were alike. You asked how many wrong turns I thought I might have led us to that aisle. I asked how often we might have crossed paths and not been aware of it. We each wondered how many scars and bruises we'd each accumulated during the years that precede our coincidental meeting among cherries and pears and jalapeno peppers. Then we turned and went our separate ways with our blemished fruit and wounded psyches, and still I sometimes wonder how many wrong turns we each have made since that chance encounter. Are we doing good? You good to go for the... Yeah, that one.
Yeah, Robbie! Woo!
Yeah, alright, thanks a lot, guys. Alright. You guys are awesome. I can't wait to get home and put these on. Thank you. You guys are awesome. You guys are awesome. Thank you.
Keep it going for Matt Lee. And if you want to trade gifts with someone, you're welcome to do that. All right. Our cute winner. Our cute winner with the... I love you, little bear. It's so adorable. It's Brittany. Brittany, so everybody clap one more time. For Brittany, it's the cutest poet award. All right, now, I just want to let you guys know, these are all tough contests. These are like neck and neck votes for all of these. I mean, Matt, you know, just edged out those socks, so you got it. So, the I Hate Love poem, though, was a landslide. So everyone needs to give it up. Oh, wait. Your prize, huh?
You can throw it.
throw these right at everyone's heads who hates. Stab them in the eye. No, don't stab them in the eye. No. Best anti-rump poem. Give it up for D-Rock. Yeah. Yes.
I'd like to thank my friends who made me write a poem, and Jesus and my mom.
Would you
ever come again?
Thank you, Jesus, for the I Hate Love poem. Alright, we've got our sexy Stevie poem, which was also identified. Hang on. Light the candles for your special someone. Set the mood. Everybody give it up right now for Bill! Yeah. Bill won! Sexy Steve poem. Everybody has to put a sweat in. Where's the wisdom, brother?
God bless fences and God bless the rain.
Right, give it to the rain. All right. And best overall poem, again, these are all very close votes. The best overall poem, give it up. Oh, wait, hold on, you guys need a prize. One more time. Very soft, very amazing. Everybody needs to give it up right now for our best overall poem, Judge Chiu! Congratulations. Snuggle up. Give some words of wisdom.
And I just have to admit, I did vote for myself.
Hey,